Hello to everyone. Today in my hand Sony Xperia C5302 for repair. It was brought with the problem of a broken touchscreen. It works, but not quite well. It happened after falling into the water. Together with it were brought two new touchscreens. Why two? Because one was bought, checked and didn't work. The second the same. And was brought to me to find effects of water. But nevertheless, they both work, and further I'll show you what was the mistake in checking of these touchscreens. Proceed to disassemble. Remove the back cover, unscrew all the screws of the rear case that you see, they are all available. After that, take a mediator and remove the back case. It snaps easily around the circle. But don't rush to remove the cover. Under it, a headphone jack cable. It's still connected. Gently raise and unplug the cable. Remove the case and immediately turn off the battery cable. Then the touchscreen cable and first of all, check two new touchscreens. The owner's problem was that he connected directly. You need to twist the loop like this, exactly like that. And so it turns out the connector was connected mirrored and definitely it didn't work. That is whole problem. As you can see, the touchscreen works fine. Let's connect the second, connect, turn on the phone and also check. Everything works fine here too. Well, let's proceed further disassembly and replacing the touchscreen. Disconnect all the connectors that you see, disconnect the display connector, as you see it is also twist. Further camera connector and speaker, next the connector of the side buttons and the connector of the camera button. Unscrew a few screws on the board, they are black, look them, don't mix them up. And then easily raise the board. This is how it easily removed and how it looks. Next, remove the battery. Here too, no problems erase. It's glued to a double-sided tape. Warm a little and easily remove it. Put aside, then remove the top box, in which there are camera, speaker and so on. Unstuck the touchscreen cable and you can proceed to remove touch. And before that, I'll tell you about one striking RPG game.
Get ready to raid. Explore and fight. Choose your champions. Defeat bosses. Win PvP battles. Raid Shadow Legends.
Further for erasing touchscreen, heat it with a hairdryer, a temperature of about 200 degrees. Take an open card that can pass between the touch and the frame and go around the frame, cutting off the glue under the touchscreen. If it goes tight, warm it up and it comes off easily. Further in the end, I don't know how to remove the cable here, so just tear it off. Since it can get out, it's not possible to take out the cable in either direction. The display cable disturbs. Well, let's remove the display at the edge of the frame. There are two screws that attach the display to the sides. Unscrew them and try to put the display out. Here is one of screws, the second side is the same, unscrewed. After that the display is taken out easily. Carefully take out its cable and after that you can take out the touchscreen cable. Next, clean the frame of the old double-sided tape. I remove it with tweezers, in this way. By the way, look under a double-sided tape, a hole has opened where you can thread both cables. After that, take isopropyl alcohol and degrease the entire surface. After cleaning, take glue B7000, apply it along the frame. Also apply a little on metal surface in order to glue the display. And first of all, insert the display. Take the touch screen and remove the shipping film from it. Pass the touch screen cable, you can level the display from the back. And press with pins for half an hour. After half an hour, you can check the phone. After a while, remove the pins and check the phone before final assembly. To do this, glue the touch screen cable to the case. Also glue the display cable. Put back the top box with camera, speaker and sensors. Don't forget to put the cam back on the camera and the cam of the proximity and light sensor. If you don't put the cam on the proximity sensor, it won't work normally. Insert the upper box, screw back the two screws on the side that holds the display. Insert the battery back. And insert the board, pass it under all cables and fasten it. And after that, connect all the connectors back, connecting them all in reverse order. Connect the button cables, further all connectors from the top, and the last to connect the battery, and turn on the phone to check. As you can see, the touchscreen works. The display also shows. For a full touch check, enter the developer's menu and check the full operation of the touchscreen. Also check all cameras, speakers, microphone and so on. When you are convinced that everything works, close the back case, for this plug the cable connector, snap the cover and tighten all screw back. Tighten the screws, put in the back cover and press with pins to drive further for 24 hours. That's all. The Sony Xperia C5302 repair is over. Did the video help or just you like it? Put like. And also don't forget to watch my other videos and click on the circle in the center of the screen and subscribe to the Art Bell channel.